Welcome to Get Sleepy, where we listen, we relax, and we get sleepy. I'm your host, Thomas. Thanks for tuning in. We feel so honored to have a supportive and deeply appreciative community of listeners on Get Sleepy. And I want you to know that it means a lot to us every single time you hit play on one of our episodes. We also love seeing all of your kind comments, your ideas, and even your friendly interactions with fellow listeners. It warms my heart to know that wherever you are in the world, no matter your background or beliefs or anything else, anyone and everyone can feel welcome here in this shared community, where the number one goal is to get a good night's sleep and to bring about a more well-rested world. So thank you, my friends, for being part of the Dream Team and helping to make that a reality. Tonight, Vanessa will be reading our story, which was written by Alicia LeVesque. We're going to tag along with two adventurous friends, Alice and her rescue pup, Quill, who are embarking on a global treasure hunt, a hobby known as geocaching. Before we hear it, though, let's spend a few moments sharing in some peace and tranquility so that we feel well set for a good night's sleep. Make sure you're nice and comfortable, finding whatever position feels best for you. And when you're settled, take a deep breath in, filling up your lungs. And then breathe back out fully, letting go of any tension and energy as you do. If you haven't already done so, feel free to close your eyes and then take one more of those big, deep breaths. As you lie here with your eyes closed, just start to familiarize yourself with the dark canvas behind your eyelids. This untouched blank scene affords an opportunity to your imagination. It's a canvas for the mind. And as you follow our story tonight, you may find your imagination painting the imagery straight onto this canvas. Though our minds can sometimes feel like a source of frustration to us, as if there's something that gets in the way of our relaxation or contentment, the mind is also very much a gift. It gives us a chance to imagine, to dream, and perhaps to even manifest the wonderful, positive things we desire for ourselves and for the world. So, invite the blank canvas of your mind to guide you into peace and tranquility tonight, helping you to eventually drift off into a dreamy sleep. It's time to wander along with Alice and Quill as they spend a quiet day in nature, enjoying their hobby together. This is where our story begins.
On a sunny Saturday morning, Alice awoke to a gentle nudge. As she slowly opened her eyes, she smiled and sleepily reached out her hand to her beloved rescue pup, Quill. At her touch, Quill wiggled with delight and crawled closer to Alice, his person. On the big, warm bed, they both snuggled deeper into the soft blankets surrounding them. Alice wrapped her arms around Quill and felt him sigh with contentment. They dozed like this for a bit, both of them warm and sleepy, until it was time for Quill to go and do his morning routine. Alice sat on the porch with her coffee warmly nestled in her hands and watched Quill happily running around their little yard. She took her first sip of the hot beverage and leaned her head back against the padded rocking chair, which she had found at a flea market years ago. She sank into it, letting the warmth of the sun and the coffee relax her body. Gazing up at her plant hanger, she smiled at the lush greenery cascading down. Much like Quill, these plants had been small and in need of care when they came to Alice. With her loving attention and nurturing spirit, they grew strong and healthy. Alice felt gratitude wash over her as she got to sit and appreciate the beauty and love that her hard work had given her. But as much as Alice loved her plants, she didn't think there was anything in the world that she could love as much as Quill. From the moment she first looked into his warm brown eyes, she saw her own adventure-loving spirit reflected back at her. As a puppy, Quill rode in the basket of Alice's bike on many days and went on numerous walks around their friendly neighborhood. After their first month together, Quill had made friends with several neighborhood dogs, and they stopped for regular playdates with their newfound friends. Seeing Quill rolling in the grass, Alice could hardly believe it. The little puppy who could fit in a bike basket was now almost as tall as her when he stood up on her shoulders to lovingly lick her face. He was a full-grown dog on the outside who was still very much a puppy on the inside. While Alice couldn't possibly guess at what sort of a mix Quill happened to be, she loved his floppy ears. They always reminded her of the sweet lab that she and her brother had grown up with. Quill was a bit smaller than their lab, with a slender build and incredibly long legs. A few people even asked if he was part greyhound, and Alice always replied with a maybe. He certainly ran like one, she thought. Whatever breeds he was mixed with, he was definitely a snazzy dresser. He had short, glossy, black fur on most of his body. His paws were white, as well as a triangle on his chest, making him look like he was always wearing a tuxedo. Alice's eyes went to the little green bow tie on Quill's collar. It had been a gift from her mom on Quill's first birthday. It was a fitting gift, since Alice's mom always called Quill her little gentleman. Not only because of his tuxedo, but also his dainty mannerisms, so unusual for a dog of his size. Feeling a breeze on her sun-warmed face, Alice knew exactly how she and Quill would spend this beautiful Saturday. They went inside and ate brunch together, Quill enjoying his kibble with a special treat of scrambled egg on top, and Alice savoring her vegetable omelet. They would need their energy for the outing they had ahead of them. After cleaning up the dishes, Alice went to her closet, found her hiking shoes, and laced them up. As soon as Quill saw the shoes, he jumped back and forth with glee. Alice laughed, assuring him it would be just another minute. Pulling her hair into a secure ponytail, Alice placed a worn and heavily marked up map into the pocket of her cargo shorts. Then she went back to the kitchen, filling her bottle with fresh, cold water. She placed the big bottle into a sling and made sure that she clipped on the small collapsible bowl which she had purchased for Quill at their local pet supply store. Slipping a few treats for Quill into the spacious pocket of the water bottle sling, Alice went through the checklist. She wanted to make sure she had everything they would need for a fun day exploring. They were going geocaching, a kind of treasure hunt. When Alice reached for the reflective green harness and leash, Quill sat down immediately, his tail wagging so fast it was a blur. Alice secured the harness into place and made sure it fit comfortably around him. With Quill growing every time she turned around, she had to check his harness nearly each time she put it on. They went out the door together into the warm spring day. Both of them were smiling, with their heads held high towards the welcome breeze. "What a perfect day," thought Alice. They walked briskly down the road, stopping whenever Quill found something he had to sniff. Alice didn't mind the stops at all. They gave her time to take in the view around her. Each neighbor had a yard that Alice thought should be in a magazine. She especially loved to stop by the Smith's yard. They were both retired landscapers, and they spent their golden years making their own yard into a paradise. Even Quill slowed down as they walked by it, listening to the calming sounds of their various water features, which hydrated the colorful plants surrounding them. As they got to the end of the street, they turned off and kept walking until the houses became sparse and they were surrounded only by nature. Soon, they came upon the sign indicating that they had reached the hiking trails just outside of the charming city park. Alice sat at a picnic bench positioned near the wooded entrance to one of the trails. "I think this is the one," she said to Quill, who sat panting by her feet. She took the water bottle sling off her shoulder and opened the lid. Pouring a generous amount in Quill's bowl, she put it down next to him. Quill happily lapped up the water as Alice took a long drink from the bottle. The coolness of the water refreshed them both. Quill flopped onto his side contentedly as Alice got the map out of her pocket. She was sitting at the entrance to the trail she had marked last time. She traced her finger along the route, observing the three different paths she and Quill could take to lead them to the treasure. She set the map down by Quill's nose and asked him which path they should choose. He rolled over and sniffed at the map, his wet nose going right to the second location Alice had circled. "It's settled then," said Alice. She secured their water back in place and refolded the map, tucking it in her pocket. They both stood, feeling replenished and excited as they entered the trail. Alice loved these trails more than any she had ever been on. Many of her childhood family vacations were spent outdoors, camping, hiking, swimming in lakes, and making beautiful memories that would fuel a lifetime of wanderlust. Of all the amazing sights she had seen, it was hard to beat the charm of her hometown. With permission from the city, a group of kind and creative individuals had placed little things along the trails for hikers to enjoy. Everything was charming and whimsical, and you couldn't help but feel that you had walked into fairyland. Alice's favorite piece was a small, ornate house that looked like a gingerbread house. The first time she passed it, she had stopped to look into the little windows and gasped in delight. Whoever had built it had taken the time to make the inside every bit as lovely as the outside. Little gingerbread people went about their lives inside their miniature world, making merry and preparing for the holidays. When Alice passed by it again a month later, she noticed that the decorations on the outside had changed. Letting her curiosity lead her, she peered inside again. The interior of the house was completely redecorated, the small inhabitants getting ready for a different holiday this time. Alice had made a habit of looking in the windows every time she passed it. and every time she was surprised and delighted by the changes she saw. Fortunately, the spot Quill had picked earlier today was very close to the little house. And as they walked up the small incline, it came into view. As if he knew where they were already, the dog quickened his steps and arrived at the house just before Alice. He sat right in front of it. Alice kneeled down beside him, putting her arm around him as she leaned into the small windows. The little gingerbread people were getting ready for Easter, dyeing miniature eggs in the tiny kitchen. The table in the center of the house was filled with delicate little Easter baskets. Alice smiled and looked at Quill, who seemed to be peering in the windows as well. She pulled the map from her pocket again and realized that the spot they wanted was just a few feet behind the gingerbread house. Kissing Quill on the top of his silky head, she stood up. They made their way through the trees, going a bit slower than before. As they walked, Alice scanned the surrounding area carefully. Her eyes landed on a hollowed-out tree trunk lying on its side. This would be a perfect place to hide a treasure. Alice bent down by the hollowed-out log, and Quill slowly walked closer to it, his nose leading the way. When his nose was inside the tree, he stopped in one spot. "Let's see, buddy," Alice said, as she reached into the spot where Quill's nose was. It was most definitely a metal box she felt in there. Reaching her other arm in, she pulled out the sizable box carefully, then put it down and gave Quill a treat. Her good boy had helped her find a treasure. As Quill sat down to enjoy his treat, Alice opened the box. Her eyes grew wide with wonder and joy at what was inside. She recognized many of these treasures. They were things she had seen inside the little gingerbread house. Whoever created it had the wonderful idea to give away some of the previous decorations they had used. This geocache was a treasure indeed. Alice looked around for a trinket to keep, and she came across a tiny heart charm with a clip attached to it, left over from the Valentine's Day display. She took the charm and clipped it to the ring on Quill's harness. He lovingly licked her face, like he knew he was getting a prize. For herself, Alice took a mini cookie cutter that would be small enough to fit on her charm bracelet. The bracelet was already filling up with many of her geocaching finds. Alice reached into the side pocket of her cargo shorts and pulled out a small zipper pouch which she kept stocked with a collection of eclectic trinkets. She pulled out a handful and held them up to Quill, who nudged a little fairy figurine in her palm. Alice placed the figurine in the box, along with a handmade bracelet, to make an even exchange for what they had taken. A big part of the fun of geocaching was deciding what to leave behind for the next treasure hunter. Alice always hoped that the next visitor would get as much enjoyment out of the items as she did. At the top of the box was a small pouch holding a logbook and pen. Alice signed their names, drawing a tiny paw print next to Quill's. "One more?" Alice asked, looking down at Quill, who was sitting patiently beside her. He let out a short bark and started back towards the trail. Alice smiled and followed her adventurous pup on to the next spot. They walked along the trails, enjoying the sounds of the forest around them and the peaceful stillness of being surrounded by nature. They passed a miniature bridge with a little hand-painted gnome statue sitting beside it, and a fake pond made from glass and rocks, with a unicorn statue posed as if it were about to take a drink from the glass waters. Maybe someday, thought Alice, she would make her own whimsical little scene to add to the wonders she found in here. A little while later, she and Quill walked into a sparse area where the break in the trees let the sunlight shine through. Alice tilted her head back and spread her arms, letting the sunlight fall on her as she took a slow, deep breath. Quill sat beside her, his head in the air, taking in the feeling of the warm sun on his soft fur. Seeing a circle of decorated benches nearby, Alice and Quill walked over to sit and have another water break. While they were enjoying resting their legs, Alice looked inside her geocaching pouch. Some of the treasures were ones she had found in other geocache locations and decided to pass along. Others were odds and ends that she found around her house or at outdoor sales. Her very favorites, though, were the handmade bracelets, which she had loved making since she was a child. Alice hoped that someday she might see one of the bracelets she had left in a geocache site on someone's wrist, and she would smile, knowing that she had found a kindred spirit. Maybe someday, she thought. She replaced the items and tucked her pouch back into her pocket before they set off for the last location. It was somewhere very close, according to the map. After a few minutes of walking, she and Quill emerged in a clearing, the golden hour light enveloping them both. On the north side of the clearing, there were a few small stumps that someone had turned into fairy houses. Little windows and ladders adorned the stumps, and tiny fairies climbed up and down the sides between lush succulents. Whoever had made these had done a lovely job coordinating the colors of the succulents with the decorations. As she was admiring the delicate workmanship, Alice saw a little hand-painted sign in the shape of an arrow. Instead of words, there were coordinates written on the arrow. Alice stood up and Quill followed, feeling her excited energy. The arrow led to a large tree, which had a naturally hollowed out spot in its massive trunk. Despite the tree's size, the hollow was quite small. But Alice knew that some of the best prizes were hidden in the smallest spaces. She pulled out a mini flashlight from one of her pockets and shone it inside the hollow. There was a little packet nested just inside. Peering into the packet, Alice saw that it was full of stickers. She smiled instantly, looking down at her water bottle, which was already sporting quite the sticker collection. Seeing that the ground was perfectly dry and packed down solid, she poured the stickers out carefully and asked Quill which one they should take. The dog cocked his head to the side, stopping for a minute to peer at what was in front of him. Then his nose went to work. It brushed over an adorable pink dragon sticker and another one sporting a colorful pattern until it finally stopped. He looked up at Alice. She scratched Quill's velvety head with one hand and reached for the sticker he chose with the other. Looking at the sticker in her hand, Alice chuckled. Her clever pup had chosen a glow-in-the-dark sticker, featuring little stars and lines in the shape of Sirius, the dog star. Alice pulled her bottle from its sling, she and Quill taking their last water break before heading home. As they relaxed, she selected a sticker from her own pouch of trinkets and slipped it into the packet before putting it back in the trunk. She placed the new sticker on the water bottle and smiled. It was a perfect addition to her collection. Getting their things together, Alice and Quill stood up and began their walk back home. It had cooled down a bit, and the fresh air felt wonderful after a day of walking. As they approached their home, they got to enjoy a beautiful sunset. Later, after a warm, relaxing shower, Alice brewed some chamomile tea and made her way to the living room, Quill close behind her. She sank down into her favorite chair, letting her body relax into its familiar, comforting warmth. There was just enough room for Quill to jump up beside her and snuggle in. Feeling warm and content, Alice reached over to the coffee table and grabbed her book, enjoying a few chapters before her eyes got heavy. She found herself drifting off with a book on her chest. Slowly, she rose and moved to the bedroom, fluffing up the pillows and arranging her blankets before Quill came bounding in. Just in time, Alice thought, as she felt the familiar weight of him settling into his usual spot. Nestled against his favorite person in the world, Quill sighed once more with contentment as he felt Alice wrap her arms around him and bury her face in his soft fur. As Alice was drifting off to sleep, her eyes gently focused on the only light in the room. Her water bottle was sitting on her dresser, and she could see the glow in the dark sticker, the faint outline of Sirius. She fell asleep with a smile on her face and a full heart.